Welcome to the next chapter, chemistry chapter 2, physical and chemical changes. Very small chapter, very easy chapter. There are lots of definition, lots of terminologies which has to be remembered. So keep your pens and your notebooks together and note down whichever things I'm suggesting that it is important. So you need to make notes. Okay, let's start. So the first is physical change. What is a physical change? A change which alters some specific property of matter without any change in the composition of its molecules is called physical change. What are the specific property of matter which are changed during this physical change? So these specific properties are density, one of the property, density. It can change the state from solid to liquid to gas or reverse, right? So density, the state of matter, then there are some other physical quantities like you can say melting and boiling point. So these kind of changes, when they occur in a substance, we can say that there are some physical changes occurring in the substance. So in physical changes, there is no change in the composition of the molecules of a substance. Okay, what are the characteristics of physical change? No new substances are formed during any physical changes. No new substances are formed. For example, ice on heating melts to form water. Water on further heating changes to steam. On cooling, steam changes into water. On further cooling, water solidifies to form ice. However, the molecules of ice, water and steam always contain two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. That is, they always remain in the form of H2O. So, if the molecules always remain or retain their original structure, we say that no new substances are formed during any physical change. So the first characteristic of physical change is that no new substances are formed. The second characteristic of physical change is physical changes can be generally reversed. They are reversible changes generally. Not all physical changes, but let me give you some examples of reversible physical changes. Zinc oxide on heating changes to yellow color. However, on cooling, its color changes to white. Similarly, when a piece of iron is stroked with permanent magnet, it gets magnetized. However, if magnetized iron is hammered, it loses its magnetism. The wax on heating changes into liquid. However, liquid wax changes into solid on cooling. So you see, all these changes, they are reversible. They can be reversed from its final state to initial state back again on reversing the conditions. Like ice gets converted into water on heating. Water gets converted to ice on cooling. Reversible change. Simple. So generally physical changes are reversible. But not all physical changes are reversible. For example, tearing of paper. Tearing of paper is a physical change because no new substance is formed when you tear a paper. Paper remains paper. But can the torn paper be made exactly like how it was before tearing? No. Second example of physical change being not reversible is cutting of hair. Once you cut the hair are cut, finished. And then you cannot join the hairs back again into their original form. You cannot do that. So that's a irreversible physical change. Yes, but cutting of hair and tearing of paper or breaking of glass, they are physical changes essentially because no new substances are formed, right? So we know now what are physical changes. There is no change in weight during physical change. This is also one of the very important quality of physical changes. Suppose if we have 10 grams of solid wax, if it melts, it will form 10 grams of molten wax. If salt solution is prepared by dissolving 20 grams of salt in water, then on evaporation of water, 20 grams of salt is left behind. right? So there is no change in weight. Weight is not added or it is not reduced whenever a physical change happens. The weight remains as it is. Only a little heat, if any, is absorbed or given off during physical change. So the last property is only a little heat, if any, is absorbed or given off during a physical change. Suppose if water changes into steam, it absorbs a certain amount of heat energy. Then steam will change into water, that is the reverse process, by giving out the same amount of heat energy. The heat energy supplied during a physical change is in no way utilized to change the composition of the molecules of the substance. Means, in changing from steam to water or water to steam, the molecules of water remains as it is. This heat just breaks the force of attraction between the particles or molecules of water. They do not change the composition of molecules of water. So this heat is to bring about the physical change or change of state in the physical change. Okay, so these are the four properties or characteristics of physical changes. No new substances are formed during physical change. Physical changes can be generally reversed, although few are irreversible as well, but still they are physical changes because no new substances are formed. So you can say, if you ask me which is the best criteria to figure out whether a change is physical or chemical, I would say just figure out whether new substances are formed or not. If there are no new substances formed, that means that change is a physical change. Okay, physical changes can be generally reversed. Physical changes do not exhibit the change in weight, and only a little heat is absorbed or given off during physical change. There are many everyday examples of physical changes given in your textbook. Go through them. Melting of ice, melting of wax, melting of butter, melting of ghee, all physical changes. Freezing of water or ice, or solidification of liquid wax to solid wax, formation of vapors, evaporation of water by the heat of sun, condensation of water vapor, such as formation of clouds, mist, fog, etc., glowing of an electric bulb on the passage of electric current, magnetization of iron, production of sound when two materials are hit together, expansion or contraction of metals on heating or cooling, formation of solutions of soluble substances in water, crystallization of salts from their solutions, change of color due to heat as in zinc oxide or lead monoxide, beating of metals into sheets or drawing metals into wires, shaping of glass by heat, sublimation of camphor. These are all everyday examples of physical changes. Always remember, in any of these changes, if you want to figure out whether these changes are physical or not, reversibility is not a criteria. The only criteria, main criteria to figure out whether a change is physical or chemical, is whether new substances are formed or not. If no new substances are formed, that means it's a physical change. What is a chemical change? Please note down the definition. A change which alters the specific properties of a substance by bringing about a change in its molecular composition, followed by a change of state, is called chemical change. So in chemical change, specific properties of a substance are altered or changed by bringing about a change in its molecular composition. So when the molecular composition is changed, some specific properties of that substance also changes, and then the state of that matter also changes, and this is chemical change. In chemical change, new substances are formed. That's the first characteristic of chemical change. When chemical change occurs, new substances with entirely new properties are formed. For example, hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen and oxygen, when they combine, they form water, H2O. Now, this is not a balanced equation, so I have to put 2 over here. I will teach you balancing, though. Don't worry about that. I'm going to teach you balancing. But before I teach you balancing, understand what is this. This is a chemical change, a very classic example of chemical change, where this is hydrogen, which is a gas. This is oxygen, which is also a gas. This is water, which is liquid. Right? So the new substances with entirely new properties are formed. First new property of the new substance formed is the new state. Okay, but that's again not a very significant property. I will show you more significant property. Hydrogen is inflammable. What is inflammable? Inflammable substances, they catch fire very easily. Okay, oxygen is supporter of combustion. That means oxygen supports fire, combustion to happen. Hydrogen burns itself, it is combustible. But water, on the other hand, it is an extinguisher. What do you mean by extinguisher? It kills the fire. Entirely new property from hydrogen and oxygen. Right? States as well as the properties, everything has changed. So this is an example of chemical change. The mixing of oxygen and hydrogen to form water is an example of chemical change. What next? A chemical change cannot be easily reversed. Chemical change is generally not easily reversed. There is usually an apparent change in weight during a chemical change. A lot of heat energy is usually absorbed or given out during a chemical change. All the properties which are written here, characteristics which are written over here, are exactly opposite to those of physical changes. You must remember these properties. First, understand and then keep them in mind. Remember them. Okay, next, everyday examples of chemical changes. Number one, cooking of food is a chemical change. Cooked food turning stale in few days, it's a chemical change. Formation of curd from milk, curdling of milk, germination of seeds. See, curdling of milk and formation of curd from milk, both are different things. Curdling is jab doodh phat jata hai, kharab ho jata hai, usko curdling bolte hai. Rusting of iron, ripening of fruits, blackening of silverware, respiration, rotting of eggs. These are all the examples which you see in your day-to-day life, which are the examples of chemical changes. Please remember. Now, a new topic which you are going to study in this chapter, a chemical reaction. What is a chemical reaction? Please note down. A change which not only alters some specific properties of matter, but also changes its composition is called a chemical change. When a chemical change takes place in matter, we commonly say a chemical reaction has taken place. So what are the characteristics of a chemical reaction? When a substance or substances undergo a chemical reaction, they show one or more of the following characteristics. Number one, evolution of a gas. Certain chemical reactions are characterized by evolution of a gas. For example, when zinc metal is treated with dilute sulfuric acid, hydrogen gas is evolved. The hydrogen gas burns with a popsun. So whenever a new gas is evolved on treating or mixing two substances, the reaction which has taken place or the change which the two substances have undergone is a chemical change, because the first characteristic of chemical change you must remember is evolution of gas. With an example, the example is zinc ko sulfuric acid mein dal do, dilute sulfuric acid mein. To zinc sulfate banega plus hydrogen gas release hoga, which will burn with a pop sound. That's a characteristic test for hydrogen gas. Kaise pata chalega hydrogen gas bana? So hydrogen gas ke paas tum agar glowing splinter laoge, splinter is your piece of wood which is glowing, okay, it does not have the flame, just glowing with fire. So it burns, it starts burning with a pop sound. That means there is hydrogen present. You also have to remember this example with the balanced chemical equation over here. Although you don't have full idea about how to balance equations and what are chemical reactions or equations, still The syllabus of class 8 demands that you should remember this equation. Zn is zinc, H2SO4 is sulfuric acid, ZnSO4 is zinc sulfate, H2 is hydrogen. Remember. When sodium nitrate crystals are heated strongly, they melt and liberate oxygen gas. Sodium nitrate heated strongly forms sodium nitrite plus oxygen is evolved. How to test this oxygen? Oxygen supports combustion, right? So a flame which is brought in contact with this oxygen, it burns more brightly. That's not written over here. I'm just telling you for your general knowledge. Third example, when copper sulfide is treated with hydrochloric acid, it gives off foul smelling gas, hydrogen sulfide. So copper sulfide plus hydrochloric acid gives copper chloride plus hydrogen sulfide, which with a foul smelling gas, foul smell, hydrogen sulfide. Remember that. So all these three are examples of evolution of gas. Next example of chemical change is next characteristic of chemical change with which we can understand that there has been a chemical change is change of color. Certain chemical reactions are characterized by change of color on reacting substances. Following examples will prove that. Number one, when red lead, this is red lead. See, if you cannot read this clearly, not a problem. Just look in your book. You will be able to find the same example. When red lead oxide is heated strongly, red lead oxide is 2Pb3O4. Okay. It forms yellow colored lead monoxide and gives off oxygen gas. Change of color, red to yellow because of chemical reaction. When copper carbonate, green in color, is heated strongly, it leaves behind black residue of copper oxide and gives off carbon dioxide gas. So copper carbonate, which is green, turns on heating into copper oxide, which is black in color, and carbon dioxide is given out. This carbon dioxide, if you want to test it, if you pass it through lime water is not your Nimbu Pani, okay? Lime water is not your Nimbu Pani. Lime water is calcium hydroxide, okay? It turns the lime water milky due to the formation of calcium carbonate. This all details are not to be not part of your syllabus as of now, but I'm just giving you extra knowledge so that you can note it down. Third example, when lead nitrate crystals, white in color, are heated strongly, lead nitrate crystals, white in color, are heated strongly, they decompose to form lead monoxide, which is yellow in color and gives off reddish brown gas, nitrogen dioxide, along with oxygen. So lead nitrate, which is white crystals on heating, gives lead monoxide, which is yellow, plus nitrogen dioxide, which is a reddish brown gas, plus oxygen. That is the second characteristic of chemical change. First was evolution of gas. Second was change in color with three examples. The third one is formation of precipitate. So what is a precipitate? Certain chemical reactions are characterized by the formation of precipitate, which is an insoluble substance. So precipitate, remember, precipitate is an insoluble substance which always settles down in any solution. It does not get dissolved in the solution. It settles down in the solution. When the solutions of two soluble chemical compounds are mixed together, following examples will prove the point. A white precipitate of silver chloride is formed when a colorless solution of silver nitrate is mixed with colorless solution of sodium chloride. Silver nitrate solution, which is colorless, mixes with sodium chloride solution, which is colorless. Suddenly a precipitate appears, silver chloride precipitate, white in color, and the solution is of sodium nitrate. So for precipitate is formed, that means chemical reaction has happened. A dirty green precipitate of ferrous hydroxide. Dirty green is a color. It is not dirty, dirty, but yeah, a green which is not very clear, muddy green, dirty green. Okay, so dirty green precipitate of ferrous hydroxide is formed when a solution of ferrous sulfate is treated or mixed with sodium hydroxide. Ferrous sulfate is light green in color. Sodium hydroxide is colorless. It forms sodium sulfate, which is colorless, and ferrous hydroxide, which is dirty green colored PPT. That means a chemical reaction has happened. Formation of PPT shows that. Third example, a golden yellow precipitate of lead iodide is formed when colorless solution of lead nitrate, lead nitrate's colorless solution, mixed with colorless solution of potassium iodide, 2Ki, potassium iodide, both are colorless. Lead nitrate, potassium iodide, both are colorless. When they are mixed, a precipitate of lead iodide, which is yellow in color, is formed in the colorless solution of potassium nitrate. So this was the third characteristic of a chemical reaction, formation of precipitate. Must remember all the examples with balanced chemical equation. That's a big task, big thing for you to remember, but it will help you in class 9th as well. If you say that, okay sir, this chapter is not in my syllabus right now, or this exam is over, doesn't matter. You have to do it because it is again coming up in class 9th. Okay, so it is hard work. I know chemistry is difficult because there is a lot to memorize and less to understand, because there is so much of information. This is an informative subject. But yes, you have to do it. Okay, there is no other option. Energy changes. All chemical reactions takes place either by absorption or release of energy, generally in the form of heat energy. Examples. There are two types of chemical reactions which occur: exothermic reactions and endothermic reaction. The chemical reactions which proceed with the release of heat energy, where heat energy is given out, are called exothermic reactions. The reactions discussed in example 1 and 2 below are exothermic reaction. Number 1, when magnesium ribbon is heated from its tip in a Bunsen burner, it catches fire and burns with a dazzling white flame. So magnesium reacts with oxygen and absorbs a lot of heat to produce magnesium oxide, and heat energy is again given out. When a small piece of quicklime, calcium oxide, is placed in about 100 ml of water, the water becomes very hot and sometimes starts boiling. It is because calcium oxide reacts with water to form calcium hydroxide, and this releases a lot of heat energy. So here we have not given heat, but still heat is produced because it's a chemical reaction, and chemical reactions sometimes can be exothermic, which can release a lot of heat when the chemical reaction proceeds ahead. Endothermic reactions are opposite of exothermic reactions. They are the chemical reaction which proceed with absorption of heat energy. Example, when sodium bicarbonate, it's heated strongly, it absorbs all the heat, it swells up to form sodium carbonate, steam, and carbon dioxide. However, the reaction takes place only on heating with the absorption of energy, and that's why it is endothermic reaction. One more example the student has written: nitrogen plus oxygen on heating at around 3000 degrees Celsius produces nitrogen monoxide. So that happens on absorption of heat energy. That's why it is endothermic reaction. One more characteristic of a chemical change of state. Now, change of state is common to chemical as well as physical change. So that's not a sure shot, you can say, sure shot sign of chemical reaction, but some chemical reactions are also characterized by change in state. So in exam, you might have this question that give examples of reaction which proceed with change in state. Number one, two volumes of hydrogen gas react with one volume of oxygen gas to form water, which is in the liquid state. So hydrogen gas plus oxygen gas gives water. Both are gases, but the outcome is liquid. Ammonia gas reacts with hydrochloric acid gas, that is hydrogen chloride gas, to form dense white fumes. Remember this, very important, to form dense white fumes of ammonium chloride, which is basically solid. Two gases mix with each other to form solid. Two gases mix with each other to form liquid. All these examples are examples of change of state during a chemical reaction. One more, red hot carbon reacts with sulfur vapors to form carbon disulfide. So carbon is in solid state, sulfur is in vapor state and carbon disulfide is in liquid state. Again, change of state, example of chemical reaction. And these are the final differences between physical and chemical changes. You might want to go through them. Remember at least 3 to 4 of these changes. Okay, because this can be asked in the exam. Also, many small questions are taken care of or covered in these differences. So you must remember 3 to 4 points from these differences. Okay, so the chapter was small. The chapter is over. It has got this exercise as well as theme assignment, which is not given over here. I want you to complete both of them. Okay. And submit it to me. Now I hope that everyone will be very regular in submitting homework. Okay, so I'll be waiting for that. I'm giving you this video now. Please watch it properly, take notes, and then start with the homework. Okay, I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.